from a Rio de Janeiro, up to 800, the Celibate priests could get married, and then some pope in the 8th century, so they couldn't get married. Why is that?
Okay, thanks, Jim. I really appreciate it. Jim, do you know who I was talking to on the phone as I was driving to EWTN Radio today? Oh, about an hour ago.
Yeah,
I was on the telephone with a friend of mine, Catholic priest, married Catholic priest. And in fact, we're going to go to a fundraiser together one night this week, and I and my wife are going to sit with this Catholic priest and his wife and probably talk about our kids.
There you go.
Okay, so there are married Catholic priests, and there have always been celibate Catholic priests. So we've had both, all right? There have always been married Catholic priests, and there have always been celibate Catholic priests. Now, in the Latin Church, the Latin-speaking Western part of the Catholic Church, the preference in the discipline has always been for celibate clergy, although there are allowable exceptions, because this is what the Scripture tells us we ought to do. St. Paul says it is better for a person to be celibate and give themselves entirely to the work of the Lord in imitation of our Lord Jesus Christ, who, of course, was the great celibate and the great ascetic who did not marry, did not take a wife, gave himself entirely. He says, I come not to do my own will, but the will of him who sent me.
The priests that I know, that I'm good friends with, they're all very happy. They love being priests, and they don't feel anything is missing in their lives at all.
Oh, that's right. Yeah, I mean, the question is based on a misunderstanding.
Sure. Jim, we thank you so much for your call. That's going to do it for us. Joseph, driving through L.A., I'm so sorry.